Welcome back to part two in our two-part series on the DALO Data Strategy Framework. In part one, we introduced the four pillars of the framework: realize value from data, manage data as an asset, democratize data, and protect data. We also provided a deep dive on the key capabilities under the first two pillars. Under realize value for data, we saw use case management, insights, automation, hyper-personalization, and data products. And under the data asset management pillar, we looked at data discovery, data stewardship, master data management, and data quality. My name is Louise Davey. I'm a business transformation architect and leader specialized in data-driven operating models and data operations.
In today's video, we will unpack the data democratization and data protection capabilities. Data democratization is about enabling and empowering your workforce to use data to make better decisions. Data protection is about ensuring that only authorized users have access to your data, that it's only used in compliant ways, and is secured against damage, loss, or theft. Data democratization and data protection are two sides of the same coin. Data democratization is about extending the use of data, whereas data protection is about limiting the use of data. The challenge for your organization is to find the right balance. And make sure to stay until the end of the video, where we'll be showing the full DALO data strategy framework. My name is Jesper Lowgren, and I'm an enterprise and data architect. I help organizations transform and scale using data.
Data democratization is the process of making data accessible without requiring the intervention of IT. The purpose of data democratization is to promote a culture of daily data-driven decision-making, transparency, and employee empowerment through the wide availability of data. There are four capabilities under the data democratization pillar. First is data literacy, then data knowledge, followed by analytic tooling and data platforms. Data literacy refers to the ability to understand, read, write, and communicate data as meaningful information. It requires a basic understanding of statistical techniques, as well as data manipulation and collection methods. Being data literate is the opposite of being data naive. Importantly, a data literate person is able to challenge the validity and reliability of data, as well as detect bias in data and in its presentation methods. Without data literacy, the quality of your data-driven decisions is going to be seriously compromised, if not dangerous. Data literacy is a skill that takes a long time to develop. This is why data-driven organizations will work closely with their HR departments in order to implement the practices that will instill data literacy through the recruitment, performance management, and promotion processes. While data literacy refers to the transverse and generic skills around data and is applicable to data in general, data knowledge implies deep understanding and information about a specific data set or data domain. For instance, someone in your sales department may be data literate, but they won't have the same level of understanding of your inventory data as, say, an inventory manager. Data knowledge implies a deep understanding of the intricacies of a given data set, including how that data may have been collected or derived, the most legitimate applications and uses of that data, and very important, any limitations in how that data can be used. Data without knowledge is meaningless, and people will always come and go. A critical part of your data knowledge capability centers around the capture of data knowledge within your data catalog, ensuring its quality and completeness. In this way, you can make sure of the perennity and the distribution of this knowledge throughout your organization.
Analytic tooling refers to the tools that enable users to perform analysis. This includes intuitive interfaces for data querying, visualization tools, and drag and drop features for creating reports without needing specialized knowledge in data science or analytics. For more advanced users, It includes the ability to access and use machine learning models and AI tools to analyze data and generate predictive insights. Common tools include Microsoft Power BI and Salesforce Tableau. A data platform is a unified, scalable, and secure infrastructure that enables organizations to ingest, process, store, and analyze large volumes of structured and unstructured data from various sources. It provides a single, unified view of all data assets and a centralized hub for data management, integration, and governance, allowing users to access, use, and share data across the organization. Data platforms encompasses hardware such as servers, storage devices, and networks, and software, including data ingestion tools, databases, data warehouses, data lakes, and data processing engines. Examples of data platforms include Microsoft Azure and Amazon AWS. Data pipelines fuel the data platform. A data pipeline is a series of steps or processes that orchestrate and automate the flow of large amounts of data between data platforms, ensuring that the data is processed, transformed, and loaded correctly and efficiently. Common tools include Microsoft Azure Data Factory and AWS Glue. Data democratization is not just about technology. It's all about the culture and processes that value data-driven decision-making and continuously works to break down barriers between data and those who can benefit from it.
Protecting data is not only a technical imperative, it's a strategic one as well. Data protection underpins the integrity, trust, and operational success of your data strategy. In contrast to the data democratization pillar, data protection aims to strictly limit the access, availability, and use of specific data types in order to reduce risk. When the data protection and democratization pillars are both mature and high functioning, they create what we refer to as a sane tension, or a healthy balance between value creation and risk management. Under the data protection pillar, there are three capabilities: data lifecycle management, data ethics, compliance, and privacy, and data security. Data lifecycle management ensures that data is accessible, or at least easily retrievable throughout its usable lifetime, including after any potential catastrophic or destructive events. There are four goals to data lifecycle management. Number one, ensure that data is properly captured and tagged at creation. Number two, ensure that data is only ever stored in an authorized location. Number three, ensure that those locations are rigorously backed up and the data is appropriately archived. And lastly, to delete data after its usable lifetime, in compliance with policies and regulations, but also to optimize costs and limit liability. Data lifecycle management is a simple but critical capability. We position it under data protection in the DALO data strategy framework because the people who are most motivated by its correct application are your compliance, ethics, privacy, and information security professionals. Data strategy encompasses a broad range of practices and technologies designed to secure data across platforms and different formats. From a data strategy perspective, where our objective is to generate value from data in a secure way, we're primarily concerned with the practice areas of data access management, as well as data desensitization. Access management refers to the process of ensuring that data is only made available to authorized users. It's underpinned by the processes, procedures, and controls that are related to user authentication, as well as obtaining the appropriate levels of authorization for their access to the data. Data desensitization, or depersonalization, refers to the process of limiting or modifying specific elements from a sensitive data set in order to make that data set available for analytic purposes. For example, a demographic analysis, where you wanted to be able to understand your customer base, but not be able to identify any specific customers or what data might be associated with them. The efficient execution of the data access management and data desensitization processes greatly enhance our ability to extract value from data in an efficient way. There is, however, many more practice areas to the data security capability. Far too many to do justice under this video. If you are interested in learning more, we highly recommend you look at the IBM Technology Channel and specifically the 10-part series offered by Jeff Krum on data security.
Data privacy refers to the protection of personal data and sensitive information from unauthorized access, use, disclosure, disruption, modification, or destruction, and focuses on ensuring that individuals have control over the personal data and that organizations handle it in a way that respects their privacy. Examples of data privacy regulations include the General Data Protection Regulation, GDPR, in the EU, and the California Consumer Privacy Act, CCPA, in the US. Data compliance refers to the act of adhering to a set of laws, regulations, rules, or standards that govern an organization's behavior and focuses on ensuring that an organization's practices align with the relevant laws, regulations, and standards, such as HIPAA or PCI DSS. Data ethics refers to the moral principles and values that guide an organization's behavior when it comes to collecting, using, and managing data. It focuses on ensuring that the data is used in a way that is fair, transparent, and respectful of individuals' rights and dignity, and considers the potential consequences of data-driven decisions on individuals and society. Data ethics is not necessarily regulated by law, but rather by an organization's internal values and principles. This concludes our two-part introduction to the DALO Data Strategy Framework. In summary, DALO consists of four capability groups that each explore a unique side of data strategy. They are: realize value of data, manage data as an asset, democratize data, and protect data. A simple analogy is that of a diamond. We want to understand the value of the diamond. We want to cut it and polish it to increase its value. We want as many people as possible to know about it, but we don't want anyone to steal it. In our next video, we'll be deep dive into capability and provide a case study. Let us know in the comment section what capability you would like to see unpacked. And if you enjoyed this video, please support us by liking, commenting, and subscribing to our channel. We look forward to seeing you in our next video, and take care till then.